Good afternoon all, and welcome back to course of heat transfer. So in our morning lecture we covered the study of thermal resistances, and we also covered the concept of overall heat transfer coefficient, and we derived some formulae for overall heat transfer coefficient for three standard cases. Standard cases such as composite plane wall and composite hollow cylinder and composite hollow sphere. So now we are extending that study to the next point. That just a minute. Now I'm sharing the screen, so we'll be able to see. So the next part is critical radius of insulation. So while discussing overall heat transfer coefficient, we took the cases of composite wall and composite cylinder or composite sphere. So composite wall means more than one materials are involved, and suppose we want to reduce the heat transfer rate, or we want to minimize and prevent the heat loss or heat transfer rate. In that case, we use insulating material. For example, suppose a hot fluid is flowing through a pipe, through a metallic pipe. If it is not covered with some insulation material, what will happen? Due to large temperature difference between hot fluid and the surrounding media, heat transfer will easily take place from the hot fluid, and its temperature will come down. Its temperature will reduce, and thereby energy loss will take place, or heat loss will take place. And certainly that should be avoided, and to avoid this we cover the metallic tube from outside with the help of thermal insulation layer. A thermal insulation layer will be provided in such a way that the pipe or tube will be wrapped around with the help of some insulating material, and that will thereby we can reduce the heat transfer from inside to outside, from inside hot fluid to outside surrounding. So now generally whenever insulation is provided, heat transfer rate will reduce. Okay, then our general notion or general idea is, if we provide more insulation, more amount of heat loss can be prevented, or heat transfer will be reduced to a larger extent. That is our idea, but sometimes it is not true. In case of this hollow cylinder, that is in case of hollow tube or hollow pipe, and also hollow sphere, it is not true that if we just keep on adding the insulation material, or if we go on increasing the thickness of insulation, it is not always possible to reduce the heat transfer. There may be some cases or some situation where due to addition of insulation, heat transfer may increase. Heat transfer may also increase. So some reverse phenomenon may occur. So to avoid that and to counter that effect and properly handle those cases, a critical radius of insulation term is introduced. So as you can see in the diagram, only a small cut section is shown. This is actually a cut section of any pipe carrying the hot fluid. So it is a case of hollow cylinder. Inside there is a hot fluid. It is at temperature Ti. Its heat transfer coefficient is Hi. Inner tube surface is at temperature T1. This is outer tube surface. Outer surface of the inner tube, that will be at temperature T2. Thereby accordingly radius, inner radius is R1, outer radius of the tube is R2. Now insulation will be provided. This red color layer is actually the insulation which is provided outside and over the inner metallic tube. By provision of this insulation layer, we intend to reduce the heat transfer rate, and thereby prevent the heat loss. such insulation can be provided. So it will have a radius of R3 right from the center. So certainly there will be some thickness, and it's outside the outer surface of this insulating layer is at temperature T3, and now that will be, this insulation is exposed to surrounding fluid, which is at a much lower temperature, that is T0. So heat transfer will be like inside hot fluid to inner tube surface, it is by convection. Then through the tube it is conduction. Then through the insulation it is again conduction, because insulation is a solid material. And then from outer surface of insulation to the surrounding fluid, it is by convection. So again, it is like it is quite similar to the earlier standard case that we covered. For that we actually found out the overall heat transfer coefficient. Just a minute. Somebody wants to join and he is not. Just let me just see that. Okay, I think everyone has joined, so that should not be the issue. Okay, now coming back to this. So this is a standard case which we just discussed in the earlier lecture, in the morning lecture. So we are considering the same case, a tube, metallic tube, and it is covered by insulation. Now this insulation, thickness of insulation can be anything. It can be anything. Okay, and we want to make sure that we provide the thickness of insulation in such a way that the heat transfer rate, overall heat transfer rate, will be reduced. It will be reduced, and it should also be economical. The thickness of insulation must be economical. Otherwise, if you go on increasing the thickness, what will happen? This heat transfer rate will anyway decrease. But at the same time, we have to look at the economy, because as material is increasing, material weight is increasing, its cost will also increase. If we increase the thickness, cost will also increase. So we have to ensure, we have to make sure that it should be economical, and it should be optimum. Thickness should be optimum. So the heat transfer rate will be given by delta T upon summation R thermal. Delta T upon summation R thermal. So delta T can be inside temperature minus outside temperature. Now for only insulation we are considering, so it will be T2 minus T0 divided by summation R thermal is R3 plus RO. R3 is the thermal resistance of insulation, and RO is the convective resistance of outside fluid. So R3, as it is a conductive resistance for a hollow sphere, we will use the general standard formula, and we will apply the, we'll adjust the variables according to the geometry here. So log to the base E of R3 by R2, this is ln. Sometimes we write as ln, and sometimes we may use notation log to the base E. Both mean the same. Okay, ln and log to the base E both mean the same. So log to the base E of R3 by R2 divided by 2 pi K2L. Then thermal resistance of convection at the outside air is 1 upon HO into AO. And area, as you know, that depends on the radius. So it will be given by 2 pi RO into L. So these two resistances right now we will consider for our argument or for our discussion. So as we increase the insulation thickness, that is radius R3 will increase, and the conductive resistance R3 will also increase. Okay, just look at this. Look at this formula. So R3, radius R3 is in the numerator. If we increase this numerator, this the whole quantity, that is whole thermal resistance R3 will increase. Whole value of R3 will increase. But at the same time, if you look at the surface area, if you look at the convective resistance, which is equal to 1 upon HO into AO, that is, area is in the denominator. So resistance, thermal resistance is inversely proportional to the surface area. So as radius is increasing, in this case, you look at this, as this R3 is increasing, what will happen? The surface area, outer surface area is increasing, and as surface area is increasing, thermal resistance will come down. It is inversely proportional. So we get to see that there are two phenomena occurring at the same time. On one hand, as thickness is increasing, conductive resistance is increasing, but the other hand, at the same time, on the other hand, surface area is also increasing, and due to increase in surface area, convective resistance is decreasing. So conductive resistance increases, at the same time convective resistance decreases. So we have to see the combined effect, because total thermal resistance is the sum of both sum of these two. So R3, one factor is increasing, RO, another factor decreasing. So the final effect will be the total resistance may increase or decrease, or even remain constant. So we are not sure. So it altogether depends on how much increase is happening for R3 and how much decrease is happening for RO. To decide that criteria, we have to do some mathematical analysis that we are going to do right now. So we can conclude that heat transfer rate Q is inversely proportional to thermal resistance. So as the thermal resistance increases, heat transfer rate will decrease. And in this case, we want to reduce the heat transfer rate. Certainly, we want to reduce the heat transfer rate. And if this thermal resistance is minimum, in that case, heat transfer rate will be maximum. So when there is a condition of minimum thermal resistance, heat transfer rate will be maximum, and we exactly want to find out that condition. We want to find out that condition where thermal resistance is minimum and heat transfer rate is maximum, and then we are interested to find at what critical radius, and thereby what critical thickness, at what critical thickness this condition will prevail. Okay, just a minute, some people are having problem in joining. I hope all are there. Nobody is in the queue. Okay. If you have any trouble, so you can put through the message box. The message box is active here. You can put you can give your feedback here. Okay. Okay. So we want to find that condition when thermal resistance will be minimum and heat transfer rate will be maximum, and thereby we can decide the optimum thickness of insulation. Now same case is taken, just the diagram is redrawn in full. This is inner hot fluid at temperature Ti. T1, T2, T3 are the temperatures as usual. Outside layer is insulation, inner is a pipe material of conductivity K1, and outside it is air or any other fluid, any cooler fluid. Okay. So thermal circuit can be shown like this. Inner convective resistance Ri, R1 is the conductive resistance of pipe material, R2 is the conductive resistance of insulating material, and RO the convective resistance of outside fluid. And total temperature difference is Ti to TO. TO on higher side, highest temperature, and TO is the lowest temperature. T1, T2, T3 are intermediate temperatures. So we can show this like an electrical or thermal, equivalent thermal circuit. And we can write Q equal to delta T upon summation R thermal. And delta T is Ti minus To upon summation R thermal. Since all these resistances are in series, so summation R thermal is sum of all four components. Now, again, it is further expanded. All four values are put in. Now, see, we are interested in finding out this minimum value of thermal resistance. Now, what we will do is we will keep rest of all other things same, all other parameters same, and we will only vary or change the radius R3. We will only change the radius of insulation, that is R3. So out of all these variables such as R1, R2, K1, K2, L, HI, HO, all these will be fixed or maintained constant. Only R3 will be changed. Only R3 will be changed. So to find maximum or minimum, we will take the help of mathematics. In this, what we do is we take the derivative of this term, thermal resistance, with respect to this variable R3, and equate it to zero. So that this condition, that is d by dr3 of total thermal resistance equal to zero, this will give us the condition of maxima or minima. First, we have to take the first derivative of this entire function and then equate it to zero, and thereby we can get some result. Okay. So while doing the differential of this entire function or entire parameter, all the parameters, what will happen is only R3 will be differentiated. The other factors or other parameters will be zero because these are constants. Right now, these are constants. So, differential of any constant is zero. So, this term which do not contain R3 term will be zero. So, these will not be considered. What we will do is only we will differentiate the terms having R3. So, we will consider this term and this term. So, first two terms naturally get cancelled out. So, d by dr3 of remaining two terms, that is just a minute. Yes, d by dr3 of log to the base e of r3 by r2 by 2 pi k2 into L. Now see, this logarithm term is expanded like this. You know some rules, some mathematical rules, such as log of m by n is equal to log m minus log n. So same rule is applied here. Log to the base e of R3 by 2 pi k2 L minus log of R2 by 2 pi k2 L. This bracket is expanded. Then d by dr3 of 1 upon HO 2 pi R3 L equal to 0. Now take the differential. Differential with respect to this. Now this 2 pi k2 L will be constant. So 1 upon 2 pi k2 L taken out. Log of R3. Differential of log of R3 is 1 upon R3. Log x, differential of log x is 1 by x. The same way, this will be 1 upon R3 minus this term 0. There is no R3, so this is constant. It will be 0 plus here 2 pi HOL are constant. So taken out of integral, differential. So differential of R3, that is 1 upon R3. R3 can be differentiated like this, 1 upon R3, R3 taken to numerator, so R3 raised to minus 1, and you know x raised to n differential is n into x raised to n minus 1, so index here, index n is minus 1, so it will be R3 raised to minus 1 minus 1, that will be minus 2, okay, and minus 1, n will be minus 1, so minus 1 is maintained in the numerator divided by R3 square, because R3 raised to minus 2, it is taken to denominator, so it becomes R3 square. So these are simple basic mathematical operations or steps that you have to understand. Then adjusting the negative and these signs, what we get is on right hand side 1 upon 2 pi k2l, sorry, one on left hand side it is 1 upon 2 pi k2l into 1 upon r3 equal to 1 upon 2 pi l ho into 1 upon r3 square. So r3 here, r3 and here r3 square, so one of the r3 will get cancelled. 2 pi l common on both sides will get cancelled out. So what remains is k2 equal to r3 into ho. From this we write r3 is equal to k2 upon ho. R3 is equal to k2 upon ho. So this is the radius of insulation. R3 is the radius of insulation is equal to k2 upon ho. That is thermal conductivity of insulating material divided by heat transfer coefficient of outer fluid. At this value of value of radius of insulation, thermal resistance will be either minimum or maximum. So one value we obtained that for this particular value of R3, thermal resistance will either be minimum or maximum. Anything is possible. To ensure whether it is minimum or maximum, we have to take the second order differential. We have to verify this, we have to take the second order differential. So d2 by dr3, dr3 square of summation r thermal, same function. Now performing this, I'm not going into details of this, you can do it easily. It is just a matter of taking the differentials two times. And taking this differential, we obtain second order derivative as this function. Minus 1 upon 2 pi k2l into 1 upon r3 square plus 1 upon pi l ho into 1 upon r3 cube. Now for this this expression, we'll put r3 equal to k2 by ho. Wherever there is r3, here is r3, here is r3, we will put k2 by ho and we will check its value. So the value of second differential d2 by dr3 square of summation r thermal at R3 equal to k2 by ho. This is a way of writing. Okay, this vertical line doesn't indicate any mathematical operation, but it is just a way of writing that the value of this differential at R3, at when R3 is equal to k2 by ho, when this is substituted in this form, in this formula, we get some value and we have to check whether it is positive or negative. If it is positive, so it will mean that R3 is a minimum value. If it comes out as negative, then it will be R3 will be maximum value. Okay, so when we do this, we get the this relation, ho square upon 2 pi l k2 cube. Now look at this, ho cannot be negative because it is a positive quantity. K will also be positive quantity. L length is also always a positive quantity. And 2 pi is anyway constant. Okay, so whole thing will always be a positive quantity, that is greater than zero. So that is why the summation r thermal, it indicates that summation r thermal is minimum at r3 equal to k2 by ho. Okay, so this way it is confirmed that summation r thermal will be minimum, and thereby at r3, that is at critical value of critical radius, the heat transfer rate will be maximum. That is why this value is known as critical radius of insulation. So R3 will be replaced by RC. Suffix C indicates it is a critical radius of insulation equal to K by H. Now K will be the conductivity of insulation provided over the pipe, and H will be the outside heat transfer coefficient to which the insulation is exposed. So when you put SI units, K and H values in SI units, RC will be obtained in meter. So graphically we can show these processes, what happens for heat transfer rate with respect to radius of insulation. So this graph is rate of heat transfer on y-axis, and the value of radius of insulation on x-axis. So as you see, as radius increases, first initially heat transfer rate increases, there is an increasing curve. So as R is increasing, heat transfer rate is increasing, and when r approaches r scene or r just comes equal to the critical radius, heat transfer rate will be maximum. Heat transfer rate will be maximum. And if we increase the radius of insulation beyond RC, if radius of insulation is more than critical radius of insulation, then we see the falling trend. Heat transfer rate decreases. Heat transfer rate starts to decrease. And as we move along, go on increasing, then heat transfer rate will be again further coming down and down. So this indicates there is some maxima for this heat transfer rate, and that will occur at a critical radius, at the value of critical radius. On the same graph, on the same y-axis, we can also take the thermal resistance. Now, what is happening for thermal resistance? Initially, it is decreasing. Up to RC, it is decreasing. At RC, it is minimum. And as we move along and we increase the value of radius of insulation, it again goes on increasing. Okay, so this is very very important graph to understand this this phenomenon of providing insulation and how heat transfer rate first increases, then reaches maximum and again decreases. So whenever we want to prevent the heat loss or we want to provide the insulation, we should make sure that the radius of insulation will always be greater than the critical radius. It will always be greater than critical radius of insulation. Okay. Now this is happening because, as we discussed in earlier part, just before the derivation, that as we increase the thickness of insulation, the conductive resistance increases, but convective resistance decreases. The same is shown on this graph. Thermal resistance on y-axis and radius on x-axis. So what is happening here? Conductive resistance, this curve shows, conductive resistance is increasing along with the increase in thickness or increase in the radius. At the same time, convective resistance is decreasing, coming down and down. Okay, and what will be the combined effect? That is sum of these two is coming down and down at one value. Up to critical radius, it will decrease. It will reach the minimum. And as we move, in the increasing direction of RC or critical radius, again thermal resistance goes on increasing. Okay, so this is graphically shown. Now the same exercise we can do for sphere. Okay, all this material is available in notes as well as in books, so I will leave this part up to you as a home assignment or as a home exercise. You can do and you can cross verify what you obtain. So finally, for sphere, critical radius is 2k by h. Critical radius for sphere will be 2k2 by h, that is 2k by h. So it is double the critical radius of hollow cylinder or hollow pipe or hollow tube. Okay, so this can be easily proved with by doing this the same mathematical operations, by taking the derivative, then checking the same for either it is maxima or minima by taking the second order differential, and just you have to check whether it comes positive or negative. Okay, then let us see physical significance of critical radius of insulation. Okay, there are two cases. For insulation. In case of a thermal insulation, which are provided over the pipe, some walls of the furnace, or even some storage tanks and all. So insulation, in such cases, insulation is generally provided to reduce the heat transfer rate, to reduce or prevent the heat loss. And there are some cases, or the other case is insulation material such as rubber, plastic is also used as electrical insulator. Okay, you see all the electrical wiring connections are always insulated with some rubber covering. Rubber covering is always there. You take any wire of your home, home electrical appliances, or even the mains line which is coming from the main power transformer up to the to your house or to your location, is always covered with some rubber material or plastic material. Okay, so the purpose of insulation in that case is to prevent the current loss or to prevent the current flow, electric current, because we are handling them, all the wires are handled by us, so we should not get any direct contact with the current carrying conductor. Okay, so otherwise what will happen, it will lead to some fatal accident, because human body is a good conductor of electricity, and if current flow exceeds beyond certain limit, like more than 6 ampere or so, we can get fatal shock, and that will lead to even death also. Okay, so to avoid that electrical shock, these insulators are used, but at the same time they also perform the job of heat loss, because as you know that wires, when they carry heat, a lot of heat is the wires, when they carry the current for a long distance or for long over a long time, a lot of heat is generated, because all electrical appliances, when they are operated over over some time, due to continuous passage of current, heat is always generated. So to dissipate that heat must be dissipated, or that heat must be removed from the wire, so that just a minute. The heat generated within the electrical conductor must be lost to surrounding, or must be dissipated to surrounding from the insulated cover, because if it is not removed, what will happen? The temperature will rise and shoot up like anything, and if it crosses certain limit, the wire breakage may take place. The wire breakage may happen. To avoid such a breakage in while working or while in operation, that the insulating material which is provided should also exhibit some thermal properties. Should also exhibit some excellent thermal properties, so that heat loss, heat transfer rate can be improved, or heat transfer rate can be increased. This is only for electrical conductors, because all the insulating materials are either made of rubber or plastic, and these are poor conductors of heat. Their conductivity, thermal conductivity, is very, very low. That is why these are used as insulators. But at the same time, they should have some minimum conductivity to ensure that proper amount of heat loss or proper amount of heat dissipation is there. Okay, so that case will also be covered. So first case is insulation when it is provided to reduce heat flow. Let us look at the critical radius formula, that is RC equal to K by H. Now see, look at this graph. Let us say R2 is the radius of outer radius of the pipe. R2 is the outer radius of the pipe. So for this, you have to bring that earlier figure in front of your eyes, or you have to imagine that. I will try to go back. Okay. Now suppose this is the case. Now here, this is a metallic tube, and over this insulation will be provided. So R1 is the inner radius, R2 is the outer radius of the pipe, and we are interested in R3, which is the outer radius of insulation. Now see, what happens is R3 will always be greater than R2. R2 will always be less, is always be less than the R3. Okay, what, because whatever insulation we provide, that is going to increase the thickness and that is going to increase the radius, outer radius. So, so R2 will always be less than R3, or we can say R3 will always be greater than R2. So when we plot the graph for heat transfer rate and against the radius, so we get this diagram. Now consider one case, one simple case. Let us say RC is this much. For some conditions, okay, for some conditions RC is this much and thereby heat transfer or heat loss will be maximum at this value of RC. And if suppose our pipe radius is so small that pipe diameter or pipe thickness is so small that it is falling within RC. Suppose the pipe radius R2 is less than RC, so what will happen? This is the heat transfer rate with without any insulation, and if we provide any additional insulation on the pipe, that is on the outer radius of the pipe R2, R3 will be this much. And here what is happening? As we are increasing the radius of the pipe by providing the insulation, the heat transfer rate is increasing. Okay, instead of heat transfer rate coming down, it is increasing because of this condition. So this will happen till this point, till we provide the insulation thickness equal to RC, the heat transfer rate will go on increasing. So whatever insulation we provide, that by that by this, instead of heat transfer rate coming down, it will backfire. Okay, it will go on increasing, and it can only be reduced after crossing this much of thickness or R3 dash. Okay, on this diagram you can see this point and this point both are same. It means that both give the same rate of heat transfer. So it is as good as the pipe without any insulation, it is giving this heat transfer rate, and when pipe is provided with insulation, it is also providing the same heat transfer rate. So it is a meaningless job. If we are doing this activity or this practice, it will be of no use. Providing any insulation up to this point will not be any use. So we have to make sure that the insulation should be always greater than this value, this R3 dash value. Then and then only we can get some reduction in the heat transfer rate or heat loss. So to ensure that we don't we end up into this area or this region, we always have to make sure that the pipe radius will always be greater than critical radius of insulation, that is RC. So before fixing up the dimensions, it is always better to check the value for a critical radius, and it is always good to fix the pipe radius, good to take the right pipe radius greater than critical radius of thickness. Either we can change the radius of pipe or we can change the material, we can change the insulation material. Taking the lower conductivity value or low okay lesser value of K can be selected. So all that description is given here. And the second case where we insulation is provided to increase the heat transfer rate or increase the heat transfer rate, heat dissipation. That is second case. It is generally done in case of electric wires. So again, the same diagram is taken for reference. So let us say this is the radius of any electrical wire. Generally, electrical wires or conductors are very, very thin, are very, very small. Okay, wires, you see, hardly they go beyond 5 mm of diameter. So radius is always like 1 mm or 2 mm, because electrical conductors or wires are very, very thin as compared to the pipe or cylinder that we see in a mechanical in a mechanical systems. So for while providing the insulation, electrical insulation, and to increase the heat loss, it is always desirable that insulation radius should always fall below the critical radius of insulation, and it should always be in this region. Maximum insulation radius can be equal to critical radius. At that point, heat transfer rate will be maximum. And the rate of heat generation, heat produced in the conductor, is given by I square R. I is the current current flow in ampere, and R is the ohm. Now this R is actually the electrical resistance that will be in ohm. So you get heat generation I square R. So any thickness for the case of R less than RC, R less than RC, any thickness of insulation will increase the heat flow from conductor. As we increasing insulation thickness from this point to this point, there is an increase in heat transfer rate or heat loss. So heat transfer rate from insulated wire will always be greater than the heat transfer rate of bare wire or uninsulated wire. So necessary condition to increase the heat flow is conductor radius R should always be less than critical radius. Should always be less than critical radius. And for maximum heat dissipation, that is maximum current carrying capacity of conductor, see, it has an inverse relationship that, or rather, heat dissipation, the current carrying capacity increases with the maximum heat diffusion, maximum heat dissipation. If heat generation is more, the current carrying, it will definitely hamper the current carrying capacity of conductor, and whatever heat is generated, that should be lost to surrounding, that should be lost to environment. Environment through the insulation material, and insulation material should be insulation material provided over the conductor should be such that it should maximize the heat transfer rate. So R insulation should equal to RC. This is the ideal condition. So whenever providing the insulation over the conductor, it is always checked for for the criteria of critical radius. Okay. So on the basis of this, there are some problems that we are going to see. I think we are at 3 p.m. So anyway, we have finished our today's part of discussion. So I will take the attendance, then you can depart. Just wait for a few seconds. All these PDF files and presentation files, ebooks, all those will be provided to you on Google Classroom. Very soon I am going to form a Google Classroom, and you will be requested to join by Google Classroom code. Okay, so we will meet again tomorrow as usual as per the timetable. Okay, thank you. You may leave now. Thank you.